I'm now doing another game that I also enjoy playing. This is Construction Simulator 2, the second installment in the Construction Simulator franchise. So basically, this simulator is all about construction machinery and heavy equipment, where you can build all kinds of things, such as houses and buildings, and in this game you can even build roads too, which is really neat. And you can even do demolition to a certain degree. You can also do, you could also clear pathways, and you can even roll over stuff, and it's interesting. I mean, there's a lot more detailed aspects of this game than the original Construction Simulator. And the map in this game is based in the United States, which I love and prefer. And the very first Construction Simulator was based in Europe. I didn't really like that map as much because it was too crowded and jammed and a little bit small. Whereas this map is a lot more spaced out and it's larger, and it's not as congested as Europe was. And plus, I also have American machines, unlike in the first Construction Simulator where you only have European machines, whereas if you're only European, then you would definitely see a lot of those in your home countries, but I've never seen any of those European machines in real life. So I'm more familiar with these American machines that we have in this game in Construction Simulator 2, which I will go over, starting off with my Kenworth T880 dump truck. And it's got a straight pipe diesel engine. I'm guessing it's got to be either a Cummins ISX or maybe a PACCAR MX straight pipe. It's got to be. It sounds amazing. Check this out. Sounds like it's deleted and tuned. I like that. And interestingly, if you can look real close at the rear, this dump truck does not have dually tires. It has super single tires at the rear, whereas most of these dump trucks have duallys in the rear, but these are all super singles, which is a bit different and a bit unrealistic for a truck of this size and capacity, whereas most of these trucks are duallys. However, the super singles are starting to get a bit more adapted to these kinds of trucks due to the lighter weight and increased fuel economy. However, you'll haul more weight with dualies. So this is super singles and not dualies, so, oddly enough. However, I chose this dump truck because it has the highest capacity of payload material compared to all the other dump trucks in its class. And I'm just about to start a job here, which I'm going to go over right now. I'm going to review that in my current contracts. And our contract here is a road refurbishment job, which means we have to get rid of the old road and repave a new road. So this means we got to mill the old worn out asphalt, or basically cut it up or dispose of it, basically. And then we got to get brand new asphalt, then pave it down, and then smooth it out using a compactor roller tractor. And now before we get started, I'm going to demonstrate all my other machines that I have here as well. And this is the function menu where you can do all kinds of different functions. So I can actually enter my machines from this function here by pressing X on my controller. And this is my compactor roller tractor. This is known as the Caterpillar CB44B. And here's the interesting part. This machine does not move on rubber wheels. It actually moves on steel drums, which can turn articulated style. So the machine turns like this, articulated. So this basically is used for compaction of soil and gravel or asphalt or whatever, basically to smooth it all out so vehicles can drive on that surface and have a much smoother experience. So the drums actually vibrate using small electric motors that are inside the drums that actually cause them to move and vibrate when the machine drives over uneven terrain, therefore smoothing it out, which is what this machine does. And there's a rubber tired compactor roller tractor as well, but that's used for soil compaction as of dirt and an uneven overburden and stuff like that. Whereas this is strictly used for asphalt tarmac construction. And next to it is the Caterpillar AP1055F asphalt paver. So this machine basically lays down the asphalt surface for a road and then widens it out. Basically, it leaves a rough surface, so then the roller compactor has to smooth it out once the asphalt is laid down by the paver. And as you can see, there's a little bit of hot asphalt that's still in the front hopper there, but I'm definitely gonna have to get more in the dump truck once we start loading that up. But before I do, I need to get rid of the old asphalt, which I will demonstrate using this machine, the Caterpillar PM620. This machine is what's called a cold planer. Basically, it's a milling machine where it has a huge milling cutting head right underneath the machine, powered by a very powerful electric motor. But the whole machine itself is powered by a monster-sized Caterpillar C18 diesel engine, which is an 18-liter inline-six, making over 800 horsepower. That's a lot of power. And this is a rubber track machine, just like the paver, so it moves on tracks. However, unlike the paver, the tracks are articulated, which means they move independently, as you can see here, like I'm demonstrating. So the tracks move in and out like this, so the machine can literally turn on a dime. And they can move independently, unlike the paver, which have to move together when they're accelerating, or separately when they're steering and turning. Whereas you can turn this one around instantly, which is interesting. And it has a long built-in conveyor belt at the front that will spit out the front asphalt, which is basically milled and cut up. It will spit that out once it's cut up. And that's what the dump truck is for. So the cold planer will spit out the asphalt into the dump truck, whereas the dump truck will then unload it off at the loading deck or gravel pit where the worn out asphalt will be sold and disposed of. And so I'm gonna go ahead and fast travel to our road building site, because unfortunately these machines are not fast at all. In fact, I'll go ahead and demonstrate just how fast this goes. Yeah, this machine turns on a dime. But top speed, it goes between 3 and 4 miles per hour. And it's pretty typical for a track vehicle of this size and mass and stuff like that. It's not going to win any races, and it's not going to be fast in any way, but it will chew up road surfaces very efficiently. And then load it into a dump truck like that. And then I'm going to demonstrate the asphalt paver next. Demonstrate its speed. But here we have to use both tracks, because if I'm just pressing the right trigger, only one track is driving, whereas the other one is idle. And if I press both triggers down, both tracks drive. And this machine's a little bit faster than the cold planer at normal speed, which is about 9 miles per hour. However, at working speed, when it's laying down the asphalt, I'm guessing it's about 3 or 4 miles an hour or so, about the same as the cold planer machine when it's underway. But in order to steer, I press my control stick. So basically that toggles between my camera and my other functions. So just like that. And so I can use my bumpers to make the machine go in reverse. Or I can do this to press the right trigger and the left bumper to make the machine turn on a dime. Just like that. But the camera will not be active. It will self-center once it's driving forward. And that's how we drive the paver. And now for the roller compactor tractor, which I will go to next. CB44B vibrating roller tractor with the articulated steering. And this is powered by a four-cylinder diesel. I'm assuming it's got to be maybe a C4.4 or a C3.2 or what, I don't know, but it's a four-cylinder Caterpillar diesel. This goes about 7 miles per hour. It's pretty decent, but I think with the vibrator on, it might be a little bit slower, but it doesn't turn real good because then again, it's articulated. So it turns around, it's got a pretty big turning radius. And the paver has I think it's a 7.1 liter inline six Caterpillar diesel. I think it's the Caterpillar C7. That's gotta be what it is. Whereas the C18 is what powers the giant cold planer milling machine over there. So now I'm gonna switch back to the dump truck and drive to my road building destination. Top speed of this is about 56 miles per hour, but that's pretty typical of a truck of this size and weight. Well, that straight pipe Cummins or Packard diesel sounds amazing. It's got to be a Cummins, I think. Yeah, probably. It probably is a Cummins, I think. Yeah, it's got to be a straight pipe Cummins. Just going to ignore the traffic here. This game auto saves quite a bit, so at least that's good. Here we are at our road refurbishment site, and I'm going to position my dump truck onto one side. As you can see, it's a small surface because we're actually doing just, we're not doing that much, it's just a little bit, a little stretch there, not too long. About a small or a medium size, depending on what you call it. But yeah, as you can see, the asphalt is completely worn down. So that's what we're gonna use the Caterpillar PM620 cold planer milling machine for. That machine is gonna eat up all this asphalt and then spit it out into my dump truck. Now, we're gonna go ahead and spawn in the Caterpillar PM620 cold planer milling machine. We're not going to drive it there, obviously, because it's too slow. So instead, we'll fast travel to our road building site in Desert Springs. I had to pay a little bit of money there for that, but it's okay. It ain't that much. So now I'm going to position my milling machine right onto the right-hand side of my dump truck. Make sure it's straight. Okay. And then there's my boss. He says, to clear the area, so my dump truck is currently in the way. So he needs me to clear that out so I can start milling. But then again, I got to have the cold planer machine right about here, and same with my dump truck. So I actually need to position my dump truck, I think, in that little spot there if I can. So I'm going to go ahead and take over that real quick. Just a little bit. Okay, now, so we have the dump truck, and I'm going to position it in the highlighted area right next to the cold planer milling machine. And this is my next instruction from my boss. All right, so here I'm going to position my dump truck to right about here. And then I'm going to hop back on the cold planer milling machine. And now I'm going to start cutting up the worn out asphalt. But before I do, I need to position the conveyor belt onto the left-hand side so my dump truck can reach it. And then I need to hire an employee to control my dump truck alongside me while I cut up and mill the asphalt. So first I need to position my dump truck a little bit more because I think I'm a little off. Yeah, I'm a little off, so I'm gonna have to reposition my dump truck a little bit more. Actually, to save time, I'll just reposition my cold planer machine. I think I'll get it to about, right about here at the start, I think. Should be decent. And then I'm gonna reposition my dump truck once again. I'm gonna get it up a little bit ahead. Right about here, I think, should be ideal. Okay. Reposition the conveyor belt just a little bit more. Okay, and now it's just over the bed. And now I will hire an employee to take control of my dump truck. And you just heard its horn go off. And now my employee is now driving my dump truck. Now, I'm gonna start milling and cutting up the asphalt. So my boss says to try and cut in a perfectly straight line in the asphalt. Because if you try to do turns, then that would become a mess. So try and make straight lines if you can. And now I'm gonna turn on the milling cutting head. And that electric motor that you just heard is the milling head warming up, where the whole machine uses its diesel engine for movement, it uses that electric motor for the milling cutting head. So now I'm going to drive on the asphalt and start milling. And now, as you can see, the asphalt is getting spit out of my cold planer machine and into my dump truck. We're gonna have to make multiple passes. So we're kind of veering off a little bit. Yeah, we will have to make multiple passes. So that means we'll have to turn around. And once I reach the end here, I'll deactivate the milling head, and then I'll have my employee get out of my dump truck and I'll take over. So I'm going to reposition my dump truck to drive in the opposite direction that we came. Kenworth is a licensed manufacturer in this game, unlike SnowRunner, whereas in SnowRunner, Kenworth is a mod. but this is a real Kenworth right here. These Kenworth trucks are everywhere, and they're a lot of fun. And they're made by the same company that also makes Peterbilt, which is PACCAR. And now, I'm going to get back into my cold planer machine and then reposition it onto the side of my dump truck once again. Make sure it's at the right position on that side. Move the conveyor belt to where my dump truck is, and then let my employee take over again. Okay, that looks to be pretty ideal. All right. And here we go. This is fun. I really like this game. I'm a fan of construction machinery myself. And hey, this gives you an idea of what they're really like to operate in the real world. It's interesting, actually. Okay, now to get back into my dump truck. Doesn't look too busy for a small neighborhood in Sunny Hills. Or maybe it's Desert Springs, I may be wrong. I think it's Desert Springs. Yeah. My Kenworth dump truck, that's got to have about 550 or 500 some odd horsepower in this game. And I think my paver, asphalt paver, has a little less than 200 or so. Same with my roller tractor. Whereas the Caterpillar PM620 cold planer milling machine has over 800. Now that's a lot of power. But hey, It's not going to win any races, but it's made for sheer muscle and heavy work. I mean, try making an 800 horsepower car do stuff like this. That will not stand a chance. No, it won't. It will not stand a chance with what kind of abuse this machine goes through. It is crazy. And now I'm going to get my employee back into my dump truck. Start milling again. This has a realistic day and night cycle as well, I've noticed and forgot to mention. So this goes through day and night pretty quickly. And of course, you know, we gotta make multiple passes due to this being a very short section of road. Into my dump truck, and that's a medal that you can get over there, a little free collectible, if you will. It's kind of neat. And my dump truck is a little over half full, and once it's full, I'm gonna take it to the gravel pit and then get rid of all this worn out asphalt and sell it off for a profit. I'll probably get on this side since my cold cleaner machine will be working its way to the other side. That side. Should be decent enough. Let me just reposition, get a little closer. This game's fun. It's a lot of fun. Make sure it's at a pretty decent distance. Like that. Yeah, there we go. Okay. These machines are really cool. You'll see these a lot during road construction. Because if you need your road repaired, then you'll definitely need a cold planer, milling machine, and a paver machine, too. And these are monsters. They really are. Alright. Now, I will hire my employee back in my dump truck. And he is trying to get position. Now I will go ahead and start milling again. It's about 3/4 of the way full. I know I'm not unloading there, but I'm loading, so. Probably back up a little bit. Make sure he comes with me. Okay, it's almost full. Probably go over here a little bit. And my employee's a little twitchy there. Just a little bit more. Alright, now my dump truck is full. Now I will give my employee a break and then jump back in my dump truck. And then I will drive this load of worn out asphalt to the gravel pit. Bit of ways though, so I'm gonna have to do a little bit of cruising here. This is the most profitable job, or one of the most profitable jobs in this game. I feel like this gets the most payout in this game. I think the maximum payout that this brings out is about 300,000 in-game dollars. Now that's a lot of in-game money. That could buy you quite a bit of machines for that price. But we're doing a small roadworks section, so this will net us about 100,000 in-game dollars, so that's a pretty decent amount. Now we are at the gravel pit. And as you can see, the day is starting to wind down and turn into night. As I mentioned, the authentic day and night cycle in this game. And now I'm going to unload this asphalt. Switch to function mode. And then dump my load of worn out asphalt into this pit here, where it will be properly disposed of. All right. and I made some extra money after getting rid of that payload. How about that? Yeah, that's a pretty decent way to make ends meet. 16.5 grand for worn out asphalt? That's a pretty good deal. And now to get another load of worn out asphalt. Wow, that straight pipe diesel sounds so good. It's got to be a Cummins. That sounds amazing. It probably had a muffler delete and a straight pipe or something like that. It sounds amazing. It really does. Now I'm back with my cold planer machine. Reposition it and then let my employee take over again. There's still quite a bit of asphalt that we needed to cut up and load up into my dump truck. I don't know why I turned a little bit there. I think my dump truck was running out of room to maneuver a little bit. So we're going to probably continue in this direction here, where I just was. And I will let my employee take over again. And here we go. Second load of asphalt coming right up. I forgot to mention that the quality in my recent videos, in my opinion, hasn't been the best. It's because I've been using the Xbox app to film these videos. Basically, what that is that this basically sees what my TV screen sees while I'm doing Xbox and all that. However, it comes with its fair share of multiple bugs and glitches. So the quality in those videos have not been the best because the whole app itself had tendency to do a lot of bugs and glitches, and it glitched all over the place, and it had a lot of, it even had a lot of lag spikes and excuse me. It had a lot of lag spikes, so it really didn't have that best of quality when I did this, due to all the glitches and the lag spikes that it had. So I feel like now just filming it like this, in front of my TV screen, like this, just with my iPad filming it with its camera, I think it'll be easier with better quality. However, it may not be the best quality, but let's put it this way, it won't have any lag spikes or bugs or glitches like my Xbox app did. So I'll probably keep filming my gaming videos like this from here on out. Yeah, that had a lot of glitches. So now we're gonna continue milling up this road. Oops. My employee is taking over my dump truck again. And here we go. Just one more pass and we should be all good to go. Yeah, it's getting real dark over here right now. But we can still see a pretty decent amount. And I apologize for the excess background noise. My mom and dad and their friends are playing poker down there. They like to do that every Tuesday night. They enjoy that. And but I apologize for their background noise, but that's to be expected. But still, they're having fun. Nothing wrong with that. Alright, this should be our last pass for worn-out asphalt. Looks like we'll have to make one more pass. Yeah, one more pass. I was wrong. Reposition my dump truck one last time. Just a little bit of asphalt left, not much. But my dump truck is now half full again. Probably go along this side. These track machines could turn on a dime if you let them. And they can go over any terrain you could think of. They can handle mud and dirt and snow with relative ease, because they are exerting less pressure on that type of ground. Although when you're driving on hard surfaces like asphalt tarmac, when it's all smoothed out and stuff, you know, it's going to be a very uncomfortable ride. Only when it's necessary, though. But still, that would not be a pleasant ride. Alright, this should be the last pass that we're doing here. My employee is in my control, is in control of my dump truck again. Okay. Almost done. There we go. And now my boss needs me to clear both my dump truck and my cold planer milling machine away from the road's surface refurbishment area. So now I am officially done using the cold planer milling machine. I will now bring it back to my home base automatically. And next, I will bring over my asphalt paver. And there I just got paid for that portion of cutting up the road surface and milling it. And now I'm gonna bring my paver machine right over there. But then again, I'm gonna fast travel because of course it's not very fast because it's a track vehicle, what would you expect? So I'm just gonna go ahead and do this. There we go. And it's right over there and ready to go. And now I'm gonna, okay, how did my dump truck get over there? Yeah, I don't know why. My employee really, really screwed that up. I don't know why he parked there. He shouldn't have. Oh man, this is gonna be a little awkward to get out of. Yeah, I'm gonna have to reset this. There we go, that's better. Okay, now, I'm gonna go ahead and take this back to the gravel pit and then dump off this last load of worn out cold asphalt. And then I'm gonna load it up with brand new hot asphalt, which will then be laid down by the paver machine. Is coming up. It's getting lighter, so that's good. I feel like this method of filming, in my opinion, is easier than on the Xbox app. As much as I love the picture of it, I mean, and the idea of it, the quality really was not as good as I hoped it would be, because it had so many bugs and glitches and lags that it was like too much to bear. And it literally messed up some of my videos that I had to reshoot and refilm the whole thing, and it was really annoying. So I think just having my iPad with its camera mode filming right in front of my TV screen like this, I mean, I feel like it may be a little bit easier to a certain degree, but we'll see what happens. Let me know what you all think about that idea of filming and quality. And I'm dumping off my second load of worn out cold asphalt. And that's all disposed of. $12,200. Nice, not bad. Now, going right under the silo that says asphalt, and this silo has burning hot, brand new asphalt that has just been mined and is ready to be paved down onto the roads. So now I'm gonna go ahead and activate the silo, and it will automatically fill up my dump truck. And it's automatically loading my dump truck just like that. It's making quite a mountain of asphalt in there. And there's a lot of smoke coming off of there. So it's really, really hot. It's about like, could be about 500 or 200 some odd degrees. I may be wrong, but we'll have to wait and see. And I had to pay a little bit of in-game money just to use that new asphalt. So yeah, that's a little bit of a bummer there. I had to repay for that. I mean, if you get a new payload like that, then, you know, you gotta pay to use that silo. I had no idea that you did that, but, you know, nothing's cheap when you're building anything, you know? It's all about the cost of money, which is ridiculous. So now, as you can see, there is all that smoke coming off of the hot asphalt due to how scorching hot it is. And I will soon bring it to my paver machine, and it will dispense that asphalt onto the road surface. Sorry, the game is a little bit laggy there, just a little bit, but let's put it this way. It's not as bad as it was on my Xbox app on my iPad. That was much worse. Not to mention I had to refilm and reshoot my Hot Wheels video in Forza Horizon 5 due to all the ridiculous amount of lags and bugs and glitches it got. So that took quite a lot to film. And I don't want to go through all that pain and suffering and pressure again when doing this kind of thing. Okay, now I'm right near where my paver is, and I'm going to line it up with my dump truck. But first, before I do, I'm going to dump this brand new load of hot asphalt into the hopper of the paver. Like so. Just need to back up a little more. There we go. And now it is loading up the asphalt. Paver is now loaded. There's still quite a few asphalt in there in my dump truck, so that'll be my next load once my paver is done dispensing that asphalt. So now I will go ahead and switch to my paver machine. This time we will use it. And now the thing about paving is what you do here before you start is that you have to extend the extensions. Otherwise, you know, this will not dispense evenly the asphalt. So this part of the machine is what's called the screed. Now the screed is what basically dispenses the asphalt onto the road surface at the very back of the paver. So as soon as I start driving, you'll see the asphalt getting dispensed onto the road surface. I just got to get up to it. Now I'm gonna start paving, and here we go. Try to go in a straight track. I'm gonna there we go. Switch between functions and camera. That's a little hard to do sometimes. Now, to start paving, the screed is lowered, and now the new asphalt is now getting paved right onto the road surface. As you can see, this machine uses up the asphalt very quickly. I mean, it drinks through it very, very quickly. And it does the job efficiently, however, it just wastes a lot of material very quickly. So now we're going to make another pass. So we're going to turn around. I'm going to use my... going to get in there a little bit more so we can see my camera. There we go. See what I'm doing. Working speed is about 3 miles per hour, but then again, that is to be expected in a track machine like this. Okay, now that load of asphalt is done. I still have some asphalt left in my dump truck, so now I'm gonna reload the paver using my dump truck again. This time I will not use my employee, because he's only there when I'm doing the milling of the old worn out asphalt like you just saw earlier. Second load of asphalt is in the paver. And now I will resume paving. Just a little bit more to go. I like that beautiful diesel exhaust stack right in the middle of the machine. That looks really cool. That really gives it a lot of character. I really like how that looks. I wish it could roll coal though, like a diesel should, but that'd be really cool. I just like how that looks. All right, now the paving is done. I am now finished using my asphalt paver. Now I will go ahead and then transport it back to my home base. And I will do the same with my dump truck as well, since my dump truck is now finished with its tasks as well. Now, I'm gonna take my dump truck back to home base, but it's got the speed, so hey, I'll go ahead and drive it back, why not? Listening to that beautiful straight pipe diesel again. Must be Cummins, it's gotta be Cummins. Almost did a tricycle and I landed it. How about that? Who says trucks can't do crazy tricks, huh? It's torquey, all right. Okay, and now my dump truck is safely back at its home base with the other machines. will dump this asphalt as soon as the job is over. Now I will switch to my compactor roller tractor, Caterpillar CB44B. Transport it over to the road refurbishment site. Ooh, and I got an achievement. Let's see what this is. Jump 100 times from one place to another. How about that? I just got a new achievement. All right. So now I'm here with my compactor roller tractor. Now, the thing is, with this machine, I like to go both forward and reverse when I do this part of the job. So, when I do this, I like to be at a bird's eye view so I can see everything that I'm doing at the top here. And so now, I'm going to go ahead and then turn on the vibrator function. So now the steel drums are vibrating. So now, that means that they will officially flatten and squish down the asphalt until it's hard and flat and smooth. However, going in straight lines with this can be a little bit of a challenge due to this machine's articulation. Articulated steering, basically. So I feel like it's easier to just do forward and reverse. Just like this. I mean, it's a pretty slow process, but it gets done pretty decently. It does the job pretty good. It must be fun and satisfying just running shit over and just crushing shit, you know, like even running over asphalt. It's actually satisfying to a degree. And of course, I will have to make multiple passes here, but then again, it's a short road surface distance. So I'll get this done pretty quick. And of course, all these machines have backup alarms, so they let pedestrians and other vehicles know that they're backing up, so those pedestrians and vehicles will not get hurt. And of course, as you all have heard, I have that kind of backup alarm on my Corvette C7 Stingray as well, that I demonstrated in an older video. And it does that exact same job. It lets other drivers and pedestrians know that I'm backing up so that they won't get hurt, and they'll know to get out of my way. And it's for the safety factor. This is just satisfying. Just squishing down asphalt until it's hard and flat. Something to it is just really, really satisfying, to say the least. Like, these machines, they're just fun. They're really fun to operate and stuff. I've never operated one of these before in real life, but I heard they're really cool, and I've never operated a cold planer machine or let alone a dump truck or a paver. I've never operated those. But I have operated a bulldozer and an excavator, as you all have seen in some videos that I have. That was all the way back in Las Vegas 5 years ago. That was a lot of fun. That was a late Christmas gift from my dad, and I thank my dad for having me do that. And of course, the machines were Caterpillar, just like these are, and you can't go wrong with that. But my dad's more of a John Deere fan, so I love John Deere as well, although they didn't have John Deere at that time. But still, John Deere makes great machines. They also make construction machines as well as farming equipment, although, in my opinion, in the construction scene, they're not as popular as Caterpillar, but just like Caterpillar doesn't make that many agricultural machines, but their construction machines are really good. And now I have just finished smoothing out the asphalt and packing it down, and I'm driving off it right now. And there, my boss is giving me the debriefing, letting me know that I finished. And my road refurbishment job is officially done. And so here is the report of my job. And this took almost an hour to complete. 57 minutes and 15 seconds to be exact. That's pretty short considering that most road refurbishment jobs can take a few days or even weeks or months to complete, depending on the distance of the road surface that they're repairing and stuff like that. Plus, I also got a 20% extra bonus too. So in this case, I actually got over $120,000 in-game dollars. So that's really good. Hey, not bad for a one day's work. Sweet. How satisfying. I like these machines. And I got another achievement, King of the Handyman and Successful Entrepreneur, which means that I earn about $2 million in-game dollars with construction jobs. How about that? New challenge is mastered, like that. Now, I will then transport my compactor roller tractor back to home base. And that's it. And now the electric vibrators have now been automatically deactivated and turned off. And then a little bit later, I will then dump that load of hot mix asphalt down the gravel pit because I don't need it anymore. But anyway, that just gives you an idea on how to do road refurbishments in Construction Simulator 2. But also, that gives you an idea on how to do that type of job in real life. So if you're a real construction worker, then that gives you an idea on how your job goes like that in real life. So this is a very fun game. I enjoy it. These machines are great. They're just fun and satisfying to operate. They're every kid's dream. They really are. You can't get any better than that. And I hope you all enjoyed this demonstration of Construction Simulator 2. Now, another thing I forgot to mention is I don't have every single machine in this game yet. So there's a lot more machines that I need to buy. And some of my machines have been idle and have not been used, so I may want to store some of them for maintenance. So I will do that momentarily. But that will be for another time. So once I get more machines, I will demonstrate all their functions in their tutorials. But you've already seen what my compactor roller and my dump truck and my asphalt paver and my cold planer milling machine can do. So once I get more machines in the future, I will then demonstrate their tutorials and their functions on what they can do. But in the meantime, I'll enjoy these machines and I'll keep saving up for buying more machines in Construction Simulator 2 in the future. And I hope you all enjoyed this demonstration of Construction Simulator 2.